Before we begin, look at the total duration time of this video. If it's too long for your tastes, I suggest you get your information elsewhere. I make these videos for those who appreciate them, not for those who complain. That being said, hey now, Rodney R. Dixon here, and this is my top 6 list of free smartphone apps, whether they be Android or iPhone apps, they're available on both, that provide free, real 10-digit telephone numbers that you can use free of charge on Wi-Fi. Now, when I say use free of charge, I mean provided you're connected to Wi-Fi, whether it be your own home network or public Wi-Fi, you can use these apps. And the free Canadian-based phone number they give you in order to contact other people. When I say other people, I don't mean other people running the same app, like Skype. None of that. We're talking contact other people on their mobile phones using their cellular network, or contacting people on their home phones using their landline, because you're granted a free 10-digit phone number, which is a real phone number. Once again, it's not a number that's exclusive to the app. Important to note, the emphasis, the focus of this video is on apps that provide Canadians with Canadian phone numbers. All of these apps, save for one named Fongo, all of these apps shown in this video also provide Americans with free American phone numbers. The reason the emphasis of this video is on Canadians is because for the longest time, Americans had access to many, many more apps of this nature, namely Google Voice. In Canada, we don't have access to a lot of these apps, including Google Voice. For that reason, we have to make do with what we can get, and that's why the emphasis of this video is on Canada. That being said, let's begin. We'll begin with number 6, NextPlus. NextPlus is the successor of TextPlus. TextPlus was one of the oldest apps of this nature to provide such a service. We'll begin. Important to note, NextPlus, despite it being the successor of TextPlus, for the longest time now, it's been like this for months, would not run on my Android 4 devices. Important to note, I've tried it on 3 different Android 4 devices. Essentially, the app will install. However, when you try to run it, it'll just crash to the home screen. Why you're looking at images of a screen and not actual screenshots is because the only device that I could find to run NextPlus is an Android 2 device. Explain that. So, as of now, as far as I'm concerned, NextPlus is available on Android 2.3, not on anything higher, and probably available on iPhone. I assume it runs on iPhone. Okay, that being said, here are the options available in settings. You could get system notifications, notification sounds, vibrate on new messages. You could wake the screen when a new message is received, vibrate when ringing, phone ringtone you could choose, allow incoming calls. Important to note, NextPlus does allow unlimited incoming phone calls. So if somebody with a landline or a mobile phone calls your NextPlus number, which is a standard 10-digit number, the phone call will come in, you'll be able to answer, and you'll be able to talk for an unlimited amount of time. The catch is, on NextPlus, I could not get this function to function unless my NextPlus app was, my phone was unlocked, my NextPlus app was opened in the foreground. If these conditions were not met, NextPlus phone calls would not come in. The new theme of NextPlus, the whole raison d'être of redoing the app, was adding this theme of cutesy characters, which seems silly. There's favorites. You could have favorites which are different than contacts. It's like a new tier. So you could have your standard contacts and you could have your favorite contacts. This is what the standard inbox looks like. Here are all messages I've received. messages are indicated by the last four digits in order for you to quickly identify with a little preview. Note that in all these screenshots, the word connecting is always visible. Apparently the app's connected and it's functioning, but for some reason, it always shows that connecting banner, which is a little troubling. Here is your call history. As it turns out, when the phone is when the app isn't open, if you miss a phone call, it will show up in your call history. As well, if you decide to place a phone call, it'll show up in your call history. Interesting to note, both of this applies to NextPlus and its predecessor TextPlus. Yeah, that's right. I wanted to make sure I didn't use successor. The NextPlus's successor. NextPlus, unfortunately, back when you used to call a NextPlus or TextPlus phone number, if the person wasn't able to pick up the phone, what would happen is they'd receive an automated message letting them know that this person isn't available now, please try your call again later. At which point the NextPlus or TextPlus user would receive a notification letting them know, hey, you missed a call, and the phone number of the person if their phone number was listed, which was great. Now, unfortunately, if you call a NextPlus or TextPlus number, you are treated to, this person is not available now, please leave a message after the beep. And the problem with that is that there seems to be no way to receive these voicemails. In NextPlus, I don't receive the voicemails. In TextPlus, I don't receive the voicemails. So where do they go? Essentially, this is terribly misleading. There's no way to turn this function off. And it is one of the reasons that NextPlus gets rated as the sixth place in the list to the top one. So, yeah, not very strong. You have contacts. Whenever you see this contact right here, it means that the device imports your contacts. This is a contact of my phone. You also have NextPlus specific contacts. NextPlus is one of the few apps, there's only two in this entire list, that allows the receipt of MMS text messages. So if somebody sends you a picture message in NextPlus, you will receive it. Interesting to note, you can't send MMS picture messages with NextPlus. What happens is you end up sending, it looks like you send a MMS, but what in fact happens is you send the other person a web link, and the web link leads to a website with this photo posted on there, which begs a question of security. But anyway, also interesting to note, in NextPlus, unlike previous TextPlus, you can't just hold your finger on a conversation to delete the conversation. What you have to do now is you have to, as the conversation's opened, open up your settings and choose to delete conversation in the individual conversations, which is a little silly. Keypad, when you dial a phone number, it lets you know how much the phone call will cost. And here's your total minutes. Of course, you can complete partner offers in order to get more minutes. That is to say, for like piddly 1 minute, 2 minutes, little amounts like that, you could install apps that the partners want you to install. Or, of course, you could pay them money to obtain credits to call phone numbers if you wish to place outgoing calls. This is what a notification looks like in your notification bar from with a message from somebody else. And there you go. Interesting to note, NextPlus was very, very poor at granting me a local telephone number. They asked me, in setting up my NextPlus account, they asked me where I lived, where I wanted my phone number from, and then they gave me a number from the complete opposite end of the country. What that means is that my phone number is not local to anybody around me, which makes it practically useless for me to use anyway. Moving on. TextPlus. TextPlus comes in at number 5. However, it is the predecessor to NextPlus, so that is to say that not everything improves with new versions. As you can see, the interface is much cleaner. Here are your initial options from the home screen. You have a selection of country codes, so you could scroll through that list. That's kind of cool that it's in there. Enable incoming calls. Unfortunately, unlike NextPlus, I was not able to receive calls in TextPlus in years. The function just ceased to function. I've tried it on multiple phones. It will not function. Unlike NextPlus, all of these other apps that you're going to see all function in Android 4 and higher, as well as Android 2.3. You're not just limited to Android 2.3, which is good. So yeah, enable incoming calls, kind of rubbish, doesn't work. You can still place outgoing calls, but of course that costs money. Calibrate echo cancellation, pop-ups, notification bar for new messages, choose sound, vibrate when new messages, wake screen when new messages, contacts notification, this is show new address book friends when they join TextPlus. That's a little strange. You could have regular text messages show up in TextPlus. In the dialer, when you type in a number here, I masked it. It once again gives you an estimate of how much it's going to cost. As you can see, I have much more credit in TextPlus than I do in NextPlus. I can use my TextPlus account in NextPlus and vice versa. However, as you can see, I have two different accounts here. Once again, you have a call history of incoming and outgoing. Search contacts. You could have individual contacts or your system contacts both show up. This is what a new message looks like in TextPlus. Tap on that. Oh, if you want to delete any of the conversations, you don't have to go into the conversation. You just long tap, and you're given the option to delete conversation, which is nice. Important to note, TextPlus has a character limit of 250 characters. I know right now you're seeing 6,098. This was a bug. I could not replicate it. Generally, the app will block you out at 250 characters and not let you type more. This is interesting. I've had my TextPlus number for easily over 2 years. I've always opened a phone. I've regularly used a phone that had TextPlus installed and connected. I haven't been using the app per se to message people anymore. However, the app's been opened and connecting. Nonetheless, despite the fact that I was using my old number but 2 days ago to make some of these screenshots, today, in order to finish off the screenshots, I am told that my TextPlus number's expired, and they want to change it. Not sure why, just the way it is. It's the way they operate. Once again, just like my setup with NextPlus, I could choose where I wanted my phone number. Fortunately, TextPlus did not do what NextPlus did to me. They actually gave me a local telephone number, which is good. It's frustrating that all my old TextPlus contacts all have a phone number that'll go to somebody else now, which is ridiculous. However, I have a new TextPlus number. Good for me. Moving on. I don't know if there's anything else to mention about TextPlus. You cannot send and receive MMS. As mentioned, you have a voicemail that goes nowhere. You cannot receive phone calls. You can place phone calls, but it costs money. You can send and receive unlimited SMS text message. Fungo. To anybody not in Canada, this section of the video doesn't apply to you. Fungo is an app for Canadians. It provides you with a Canadian local telephone number. As far as I'm concerned, it does not cater to the States. Here are the options from the initial option screen. It's one of the few apps that you could actually exit. You don't have to have it running all the time just because it's installed. Settings. Now, Fungo does not cater as much to SMS as it does to voice. When it comes to a voice service, Fungo prioritizes voice, and it does so brilliantly. I think you'll agree once you see all the options. Set ringtone, contact ringtones, ringtone mute, vibrate when ringing, messaging tone, notification mute, sound effect mute, pulse notification LED. Integrate call history, receive cellular SMS, show my caller ID, so you could elect not to show your caller ID when you call people. Rings before voicemail, one. Call forwarding, you could have free call forwarding to another phone number. You could block numbers. You could sync your Fongo number. You could link your phone number to allow other Fongo users to find you. Sort by display order. You could use Bluetooth. You could use 3G. It'll remind you when you're on 3G. Show connected notification. Start screen. I elect to start the app on my voicemail, which is pretty cool. Start on phone startup. It doesn't have to if you don't want it. You could have it just start on incoming call, which is pretty cool. A phone call comes in and the app starts up on its own. Start call on a dial pad in case you need to deal with automated systems. Automatic speaker source. Show message preview. This is for incoming SMS text message. You'll get it in your notifications. All this applies to SMS, which, although incoming SMS is free, outgoing SMS is not. You have to pay in order to do that. If you do pay, you could send read receipts and show emoticons picker. Open links with Android browser, who cares? Enable the proximity sensor, use system proximity sensor, alternate Fongo connection, microphone volume, receiver gain, use JAV audio, use low bandwidth codec, enable echo canceller, use alternate echo canceller. As you can see, the focus is on the phone calls. Use alternate call stream, restart audio when on call, play ringtone as alarm sound, use Wi-Fi lock, debug mode, and make a test call. In your contacts, once again, you could have your own Fongo contacts. It also imports your system contacts. In the app is an integrated yellowpages.ca, which is strange because I guess it's practical considering you don't need to have the Yellow Pages app installed. It uses GPS, also Google location services for this example. I selected restaurants. It selected restaurants close to me. In selecting any of the options, it tells you how much it's going to cost to call the person at the company. It gives you the company's phone number or address. You could also navigate to, or you could show a map of the address, and by choosing to navigate to it, it opens up Google Maps navigation. Incoming call, this is how it displays. Here it's anonymous because I was using an anonymous number. However, generally it shows the caller ID. If you miss the call, this is what you see in your notifications, along with this icon, the red receiver. There's a news feed with Twitter-like Fongo news. There's a call history. Voicemail. Unlike every other app I'm going to show in this system, the voicemail on Fongo is pretty close, if not identical, to the voicemail service you'd receive from a mobile phone carrier, in that when you connect to voicemail, it actually dials out a phone number to connect to an automated system that has your voicemail. You could set voicemail greetings, you can delete messages, re-listen to messages, and what have you, archive messages, all that good stuff. Also, your voicemail also downloads to your phone, so you have a local copy of it, so you can play it locally. You could delete the message locally. Be forewarned with this email message. I tried this myself. However, once trying it, it wanted to send the message by Bluetooth, so not so much email. This is what an SMS notification looks like when it comes into your Fongo number. As you can see, this is what it looks like. However, you can't reply without paying for the service. If you long hold the message, you can choose to delete, add to contacts, or call the person. Like the previous two apps, when you dial out a number that costs money, it will tell you how much the fees cost. Important to note, with Fongo, if you're local to a major Canadian center, for example, myself, when I call Montreal, I'm local to Montreal, so I'm considered part of the greater Montreal area. People using Fongo to call my phone number, and I mean my home phone number, my landline, is free. Calling any major metropolitan city in Canada using Fongo is free. When you call more rural areas or more, separated farther from major metropolitan area numbers, it's then that it suggests that you pay a fee to make the phone calls. So there you go. That is Fongo. Fongo, best voicemail system out of all of them. Most robust call features. Calls to major metropolitan areas are free. All incoming calls are free. Free voicemail, caller ID, all that good stuff. Moving on. Pinger Text Free. This app went through many different, I don't want to say rebranding, but many different facelifts. And its current iteration doesn't change the fact that all iterations of Pinger Text Free have always been very Google Mountain. They are very... Now, this is based on Android. I can't speak for iPhone. However, on Android, regardless of which Android system you're using, Text Free or Pinger, if you're just using the Pinger app, which is the same app, just different name, just drinks system resources, memory, CPU clock cycles, RAM, speed, eats it all up. That's a downside. However, in settings, you have your phone number, get minutes, so you could use partner offers to get minutes or you could pay them. You could change your ringtone, your text tone. You could change your voicemail. This is a voicemail greeting. This is fairly new, by the way. You could have a signature to your messages. Enable notifications, show message preview, notification pop-up, native messages, send text-free voice calls to voicemail. So essentially, you could turn off the incoming calls and have them go straight to voicemail, which is good. This is what the inbox looks like. Important to note that when switching from phone to phone, your conversations no longer come with you. They used to. Now they don't. This is what advertising looks like. As you can see, the banners are large. There's also advertising built into the your inbox, if you will. See, sponsored. You have contacts, once again, system contacts, as well as contacts you add to the app. Unlike the previous apps, when you enter a phone number, it doesn't let you know how much it's going to cost you. However, outgoing calls, like all the other services thus far, aside from Fongo, cost minutes. Lets you know the quality of the connection. This is the way a incoming voice phone call appears. Incoming voice calls are completely free. So when people call your phone number, your ping or text free phone number, completely free. As with all the apps shown thus far aside from NextPlus, and only because NextPlus is dysfunctional as far as that functionality, but it should be. Theoretically, they want it to be where you could receive phone calls for free. It's the way it looks when you're connected to a voice call. Speaker, mute. You have those functionalities. What you can do is you can... Oh, in your notifications, it lets you know that you're connected. So you could leave the app and still be connected to a phone and still use your smartphone. This is the way a notification pops up on your screen when you receive a message. An SMS text message. Picture messaging. Unfortunately, it doesn't function. It only functions in the US when SMSing you or MMSing US numbers. I wouldn't know. I haven't tried it to a US number. This is the way a conversation appears. When you either reject the phone call or can't pick up your phone, you receive a notification if you have a missed call and voice message. Once again, this says unknown number because I was using a masked number, but generally it lets you know the caller ID. When you open up the conversation, you have a little call history and you can play the message locally. And this banner applies to both Text Plus, as well as Ping or Text Free. Every time you finish a phone call or try to escape the app, you are presented with a sponsored screen, which you can dismiss by just tapping the X. The beauty of Text Free is that you can also use it from the website. Now, important to note, the text-free website is not very robust. It doesn't have nearly the same functions. What you can do... Oh, important to note, what I'm showing here is, out of all of the services we've shown thus far, and of all the services that will be shown in this video, text-free, Ping or text-free, is the only service, that if you try to send an SMS text message and it does not go through, it will actually let you know, which is pretty impressive, especially if you're trying to, for example, contact a bunch of companies and you want to see if you could write them instead of calling them. If you receive this notification, yeah, no, it's just a voice number. So that's pretty cool. This is what the interface looks like. So when using the web interface, you're limited to, I think it's 150 characters or 160 characters. Right now it's saying 136 because it always puts that signature. You can, of course, delete it with every message, which is good. Important to note, the app sadly doesn't update itself as one would hope. So for example, you'll receive an incoming message maybe twice, and then after that you will not receive any more incoming messages. It just won't work. Even if you try to refresh the page, it will not work. The only way you could receive new messages is if you completely reload the main URL, re-log in, then you'll receive your new messages. Fortunately, you can use the service in conjunction with your phone app. So if you have both your phone app open and this website open, what you can do is you can type messages through text-free web and receive messages on your app all concurrently, if you will. And that's a nice way to be able to type SMS using a keyboard instead of having to use a phone. Moving on, number two in our countdown is Text Me. Now, the reason I'm hesitating here is because it has another name. They rebranded to Freetone. However, both Text Me and Freetone are both available. They're both essentially the same app. The only difference is that Freetone has more advertising. So I recommend you go with Text Me. Here are the options of Text Me. Oh, I didn't touch on what number I was granted for for Ping or Text Free. So Ping or Text Free back in the day, when I first made my first account, and this is pretty biased, I made my first account using an Android device, and being in Montreal, Quebec, they gave me a number for Kingston, Ontario, which was far and did not agree with me. However, when I then set up another account using an iOS device, not even an iPhone, an iPod Touch, the iOS device granted me a local 514 number. And I got this trick from my buddy who was testing out this app, Pinger, with me back in the day. And he had an iPhone, and he was in Switzerland, of all places. And I couldn't believe that me being local to Montreal received a Kingston, Ontario number, yet my buddy in Switzerland received a local Montreal number. That's where I got the idea. So, if you need a number, well, anyway, I can't. The chances of you being in Montreal and wanting to use text-free are pretty slim, but that's my story. There you go. Moving on. Freetone or Text Me. Here are the setup. You can personalize your voicemail greeting. Personalize your ringtone, personalize ringtone, notification sound, personalize notification sound, message preview, play sound, vibrate, quick reply, alert banner, that's unique to this app, out of all the apps I'm showing in this video, vibration, sound, font size, background image, auto hide keyboard, signature, lock code, log out, delete your account, incoming calls, echo management. This is the only app that supports Google Glass, MyWare, and Pebble, like native to the app. You could link your Facebook account. Not sure why you want to do that. If you punch in a phone number, you're given an estimate, 1 credit a minute, and I have 9 credits to my name. Contacts, you could have individual app contacts as well as your device contacts. Incoming call, you have access to all these functionalities. You could answer or decline. When you're connected to a phone call, once again, it can remain in your notifications, so you could use your smartphone while you're on the phone. However, important to note that in TextMe or Freetone, you cannot use the app aside from messaging the person you're contacted, you're connected with, if you're in a phone call with them, which is kind of frustrating because in the other apps you can, you know, contact other people using the same app while you're on a phone call. In this one, no. You could only contact the person you're in a phone call with. If you, this is the way the inbox looks, by the way. If you miss a phone call or deny a phone call, voicemail comes in. That's the way the notification looks. You can play the voicemail locally. Banners float around in your conversation. That's the way the advertising works. This is the way a pop-up looks. Now, you can see the pop-up's pretty useful. Oh, this is the way the banner looks, by the way. It has a banner that changes the message per second each time a new, if the many messages come in. It tells you who's calling, gives you a preview, and you can reply right in the little pop-up. You could, of course, expand the pop-up, which opens the app. But this is what's silly. You can't dismiss this. You could call the person, video call, but you can't dismiss. The only way you could dismiss this is if you use the home button of your device, which is kind of silly. This is what a notification looks like in the notification bar of a message. And are we on? Yeah, we're on the next app. So there you go. When it came to TextMe, as far as phone numbers, TextMe at first granted me a local phone number, no problem. Now here's the rub. Oh, I should touch on other things about TextMe, which are just not fun. See this icon right here? This means the voice service is connected. There's no way to get rid of this icon. If you use TextMe, you will always have this notification in your notifications. You can't get rid of it. It's always there. Furthermore, I've been using a phone that connected to TextMe for a couple of months. Shouldn't exaggerate, excuse me. So I've been using a smartphone that's been connecting to TextMe for months. However, I haven't been using the app to record this video. I open up the app, and lo and behold, it changed my phone number. It didn't even let me know that my phone number had expired. All this time I was connecting to the app, and we're talking connecting daily here. But they decide, you know what, we're just going to magically change your app, not tell you, and all of a sudden you have a new number. The new number they gave me is not local. It's kind of frustrating. So yeah, that's another downside to TextMe or Freetone. And finally, number one, the big, big winner of our top six countdown. This app is called TextNow. In settings, you have voicemail, screen lock, record call diagnostics, notification sound vibrate, LED light, ringtone, voicemail, screen lock. I thought I showed some of these. Record call diagnostics. Notification sound, vibrate, a light. I did show that, I'm sorry. Yeah. Whatever. Voicemail service, you could turn it on. You could have a custom greeting. As you could in TextMe, I think I mentioned that. Freetone. Notification sound, vibrate, LED light, signature, floating chat. This is very useful. Quick reply, lock screen quick reply. I didn't show it in this video, but when your screen is locked, it could wake your phone, and on the lock screen, show a dialogue where you can, similar to text me, you could read the message and quickly reply, which is nice. Show all timestamps, email notifications, very useful. Unified inbox. Search, you can search for either contacts or messages, which is pretty cool. By the way, coming back to text me slash Freetone, I'm sorry, I forgot to mention. Text me and Freetone, when you change from device to device, similar to Pinger Text Free, your inbox does not transpose from one device to the other. So if you have many different conversations going and you change to a different device, your conversations won't be there. It's like that for both Pinger Text Free and TextMe slash Freetone. However, that isn't the same with our winner over here, TextNow. So, to recap, TextNow, what's the other two? TextPlus and NextPlus. Your inbox, if you will, transposes from one device to the other if you log on to different devices. Search for contacts or messages, as I was saying, that's pretty unique. You don't see that very often. You have a call history. This is the way a floating chat looks. So you're using your device and all of a sudden that shows up. And when you tap on it, it opens up and it shows you the conversation. And you can, of course, reply and what have you. You could call the person, other options. And this is right on your home screen or any other screen. And it pops up unintrusively. It doesn't just pop up in your face, it just pops up with that little icon. And you tap that little icon and this guy opens up, which is really useful. And when you're done with it, you just hold it and you drag it down and a little X shows up down here, and when you drag it to the X, it disappears. Also, you have your notification up here, as you could see. This is what a standard conversation looks like. Coming back to it, you can copy and paste large messages in TextNow. You could not do that in TextMe or Freetone. You can't copy and paste. It won't let you, period. You can copy and paste large messages into Pinger Text Plus. Pinger Text Free. Yes, you can't do so on the web applet, obviously, because there's a character limit of 150 characters. This is the way an incoming call looks, like with all of these apps. In fact, all of these apps all allow unlimited incoming calls, aside from Text Plus, but that's because it's defective in the app. Could accept or reject. If you reject and you get a voicemail, you have a notification with a caller ID. In this case, it's a fake caller ID, obviously, using a fake number. This is the way new messages appear, as well as new voicemail and what have you. Here's what your inbox looks like. You could open up your dial pad here, or write a new message with this. Your voicemail, when you tap on it in the conversation, it opens up this little window that's not streams it, but it plays it, if you will. When you dial out a number, it does not estimate how much it's going to cost you. However, look at this. Unlimited. Now here's what I don't understand. In the store, you have 5 credits. 5 minutes of talk time to any US or Canadian number. You could also earn credits. Now I don't know if there's a bug in my account, a promotion in my account. You see, or maybe TextNow has changed their policy. All I know for certain is that I've seen that I've had 5 credits ever since I started using the app a couple of months ago. I've certainly dialed much more phone numbers than 5 and talked for much longer than 5 minutes worth dialing out. And my credits have never disappeared. And this lets me know that I could talk unlimited. Furthermore, when I used a web app, I'll get to that in a minute, it lets me know that I could talk as long as I want and there's no limit. So, I don't know what's going on, but as far as I'm concerned, I've tried tapping just random numbers, trying to find a number where it says the phone call isn't unlimited, and thus far I haven't found one. So as far as I could tell, if I'm wrong, let me know in the comments section of this video page, but as far as I could tell, text now supports unlimited outgoing calls to, now I can't confirm this, but I'd assume Canadian and US numbers. I know all of the phone numbers that I've dialed in the Montreal area have all been unlimited. So, I don't know. Take that with a grain of salt, I guess. TextNow, like Ping or TextFree, has a web interface. Fortunately, the web interface works a lot better. Unlike Ping or TextFree, in order for me to use the TextNow web interface, I have to use it in Google Chrome. As you can see, you have your call history here, which you could scroll up and down. As I said, it transports with you from different devices. You could receive missed call notifications. You could also check your voicemail in the web interface, which is awesome. Similar to the Ping or TextFree web interface, you could use this concurrently with your app opened and running. Unlike Ping or TextFree, there doesn't seem to be a small character limit on the sizes of SMS text messages you send out using the web interface. Not to mention that you also receive incoming SMS text messages regularly. It's not like Ping or TextFree where you receive two and then, well, you gotta reload the entire page. No, no. This, you can leave it open and you'll constantly receive new SMS text messages, which is nice. Essentially, the function works, which is good. You could even attach MMS, like I said. Oh, I didn't say this. TextNow is the only app out of all of these apps that I showcased that you can both send and receive MMS picture messages free of charge to Canadian numbers, which is pretty impressive. Interesting to note, you'll notice that there's a button, Enable Calling. Now, I can't get this to work anymore, but once upon a time, I was able to both send and receive voice telephone calls through the web interface, which was awesome. However, I can't get it to work recently, so I know they implemented some changes, some fixes, and it's not working out anymore. I gotta warn you, the website is resource heavy. A lot of it has to do with these banner advertisements that they implemented. When they first started this up 2 months ago, well, I shouldn't say first, but when I used it 2 months ago, there was no banner advertisements and I could have this page running all day. I could also send and receive phone calls, funny, huh? But now that the banner advertisements are there, I may be able to use it for 35, 40 minutes. And then my system just becomes too slow to use. TextNow, as mentioned, you receive emails, or you could turn them on, to let you know when you have a new SMS text message. If you click on reply, it opens up that web interface that you saw. So it gives you the actual message and who sent it. Same thing with voicemail. You're notified when you have voicemail and from who. You can't listen to it in your email, unfortunately, but when it comes to TextNow, TextNow did grant me a local telephone number, which I still have, I still use, and given the versatility, flexibility, and just completedness of TextNow, it is my number one app of choice for free 10-digit authentic, real Canadian phone number that you could use to contact, obviously, phone numbers, whether they be landline, mobile, whether it be, in this case, voice, SMS, or MMS, and of course all of the added bells and whistles of the web interface and email notifications and all that good stuff. It's the complete package. It really is impressive. TextNow. What I'm showing now is Google Hangouts Installer. Now, this does not function. This does not factor into the top six. but it's a good accompaniment to these apps. Essentially, what this is something that Gmail users, desktop computer Gmail users, have long wanted, especially if you used a Google Call phone feature. Essentially, from Gmail, for those who don't know, as of this date of recording, you can place voice calls to phone numbers, authentic phone numbers, through Gmail, through the web, completely free of charge. You can call real phone numbers and talk for as long as you want using your computer, using a microphone and earphones or the mic on your computer and speakers, what have you. Well, finally, Google has listened to the critics who would say, listen, there's a Hangouts app on the phone, but we can't place calls with it. Finally, they've created the Hangouts dialer. So provided you have, and I can't speak for iPhone, but provided you have an Android 4 phone or up, and you have something, unfortunately it's heavy, you have like 150 megs free on your phone, you have to download the Google Play Services framework, the newest version of Hangouts and Hangouts Dialer. You can now, in Hangouts, tap on the phone icon and place phone calls to any phone number you wish. As you can see, as long as it's in Canada and US, it doesn't cost a dime. You could, of course, add credit to actually make international calls. Here you go, place call. You can mute the microphone, you can bring up the dial pad, you can put it on speaker. And this is when a call is connected. The reason I'm showing this is, once again, this is a great accompaniment. This was the app I was using to make all those phone calls that were showing up as anonymous. The app is beautifully quick, it's simple, it runs well, and what's great about it is no large annoying advertisements. It's not very system resource hungry, so it works great, it works quick. The phone call quality is great, the latency, the lag between when you transmit and when the other person receives is very good, and once again, free. Everybody has access to it if they have an Android device, because they're already signed in with a Gmail account. And for iPhone users, guess what? A Gmail account is actually the easiest and quickest email account to make this day and age. Unfortunately, I'm not a fan of the Gmail email service, but having a Gmail account for this, I think, is worth it. So once again, in order to get this, keep in mind, well, important to note, you cannot receive calls. All the calls you place are from an anonymous phone number, so people can't return phone calls. Also, it doesn't work with SMS text messaging. It only works with placing phone calls. However, once again, completely free, unlimited phone calls to anywhere in Canada and US, and the app works super quick. You require Google Services Framework, Google Hangouts app, and the Google Hangouts Dialer app. All Google products, and they all integrate seamlessly. Finally, what I'm showing here, the last little bit of this video, is how apps register, or how it handles large blocks of text. Now, this is the way NextPlus, which was number 6 in our list, can send large messages, large blocks of messages. This is how it appears in text now. It cuts it up into small 3-line blocks. Text Now, which is my app of choice, my number 1 app of choice, this is how a message from it went to Text Free. Pinger Text Free cuts it up into, once again, 3-line blocks. NextPlus, number 6, to, once again, Pinger Text Free, excuse me. Here you go, broken up as so. Text Now to Text Plus. Text Now, my number 1 choice, to Text Plus, my number 5 choice. Look at this. Text Plus actually accepted the messages, and Text Plus was the only app to actually number them when they came in, so you knew what belonged to what. Because generally when you receive big blocks of text, they're usually jumbled. They're not in order, unfortunately. And finally, Text Me, my number two app. This is how it received a Text Now message. And chances are the blocks are the same size. They just look different, given the fact that they're spaced out more. There you go. Just a little idea if you want to send huge blocks of texts. You'll notice that I didn't mention all apps here. And the reason for that is due to the fact that apps not only have problems sending large blocks of text, but certain apps will just quite simply put refuse them. They won't allow the message to come in. I've performed this test with every single app I showed in this video, writing every other app shown in this video. And for example, Fongo wouldn't accept any large blocks of text from any phone numbers. The ones that I did show were the only ones that accepted large blocks of text. So, we got here Text Now, my choice, Text Free, Text Plus, oddly enough, Text, and one from Text Me. I remember Text Me would only take large blocks of text from Text Now, it wouldn't take large blocks of text from any other service, which is interesting. So there you go, just to give you an idea. Interesting to note, I didn't showcase NextPlus in these screenshots, and that's because NextPlus, when it has large blocks of text, if you try to scroll, a bug makes it snap back to the bottom all the time, so you can't scroll upwards, so it kind of makes large blocks of text pointless. As you know, Text Me or Freetone does not allow copy and paste of message, so I couldn't show any of the any of these, with Freetone being the sender. Of course, Text Plus has a character limit of 250 characters, so couldn't use that to send large blocks of text. And I think that pretty much covers it. I really don't think I missed anything. If I did miss anything, I will mention it in the annotations and, of course, in the description field below this video window. Yeah, I'm not going to waste any more of your time scrolling through this quickly. I'll just leave you with that. So once again, I will go through my picks real quick. My number one best pick is, of course, Text Now, followed by Text Me, which is also Freetone, but I'd choose Text Me over Freetone, given the less advertising, followed by Pinger Text Free. Don't forget that whether you get Pinger or Text Free, it's all the same app, but it is very memory and resource hungry intensive. Followed by Fongo, once again, that only applies to Canadians. It's the only app that you can't send and receive SMS text message, you can only receive. And that's followed by Text Plus, and followed by Next Plus. Well, I'll leave you with that. I hope this information helps, and as usual, all the best.